people have been interested in the colors of dinosaurs as long as they've known the fossils existed. They interpreted the colors of dinosaurs based on living reptiles, scaly and usually dark browns or muted greens. In the late 90s, people began to discover feathered dinosaurs, dinosaurs with dino fuzz. At that point, it became interesting to know how those feathers could have influenced the appearance of them.
What we found out is that fossil feathers, they preserve the melanin, that is the pigment that gives the color to the feather. So the way that I got the idea that we could potentially use this to put colors in dinosaurs came from a very odd angle, because I was actually looking at fossil squids, and we find fossil squids that have the ink sac preserved. And quite interestingly, when you look at this fossilized ink, you can actually see that it preserves the pigments. And that made me think that we should be able to find this pigment, which is melanin, in other kinds of fossils, such as in, for example, feathers.
Melanin pigments are created by pigment cells, which package them in little organelles called melanosomes. These melanosomes are tiny little packages. They come in oblong or rounded shapes.
We have a locality in Denmark that is about 55 million years old, where we find fossilized birds with feathers. So when I took this fossil under a scanning electron microscope and started zooming in on the fossil feathers, I was just met by this ocean of little sausage-shaped structures, and that confirmed my expectations that melanin is very abundant in fossils. And also, it means that we can use this sort of information to put colors on dinosaurs.
What we were able to do was compare the shape and size and density of the melanosomes in these fossil feathers to the feathers of living birds, and thereby interpret or predict the color of these fossil feathers when the animal was alive. This has allowed us to create the first description of the plumage color of an extinct dinosaur in history.
The dinosaur is an animal called Angiornis, and it's about the size of a chicken, and it has a rather spectacular plumage, including a red color on the crest and spotting and bracketing of black and white and gray colors on the rest of the plumage.
What Rick, he said when he first saw this thing and we started realizing what kind of color patterns it had, he said it looks like a spangled Hamburg. If you see this Angiornis, as it's called, and just have a quick look at it and look away, I think most people would say that it looks like a chicken.
This fossil is from the latest Jurassic of Liaoning province in China. So these Chinese examples are extraordinary in that many of them do have an outline of the feathers on both extinct birds and these early dinosaurs.
And so the interesting prospect of this is that we can see that melanin is preserved in all these fossil feathers. It's the rule rather than the exception.
The future in dinosaur paleontology, and literally the paleontology of birds and mammals, will be that we will probably be able to reconstruct in some detail the color that they had in life. This is like writing the first field guide page in the field guide to the dinosaurs, and it's one of the most exciting moments of science I've ever had.